Joining us today is Republican Senate President Mike Haradopoulos, one of the lawmakers who put that on the ballot. Thanks for coming in here today, lawmaker from Melbourne. And on the phone, we've got Deirdre McNabb, president of the League of Women Voters, which opposes Amendment 3. And Deirdre, I just want to make sure, can you hear us?
Yes, I can. I hope you can hear me.
All right. Yes, we can. Loud and clear. First, what we're going to do is show on the screen right now to voters and folks at home exactly what Amendment 3 says. The proposed amendment to the state constitution replaces the existing state revenue limitations based on Florida personal income growth with a new state revenue limitation based on inflation and population changes. It continues to say state revenues collected in excess of the revenue limitation must be deposited into the budget stabilization fund until the fund reaches its maximum balance and thereafter shall be used for the support and maintenance of public schools. First of all, I have to know, did you draw that language?
We did. We worked with the courts to make sure it's very clear, to make sure that we never spend money when times are tough, and we make sure we have the right amount of resources and balance out. Kind of like when times go well, let's put money in the savings account and not overspend. So when times go tough, we draw from that savings account. So we don't have that up and down budget like we have for too many years now.
Deirdre McNabb, do you see it that way?
Well, no, we actually see this as one of the worst ideas that Floridians will face on their ballot in a long time. This has been a disaster in the state of Colorado. Senator Haradopoulos likes to say it's different. It's pretty much almost the same thing. Chamber of Commerce, state of Colorado, says it's been financial quicksand for the state. Almost 30 other states have turned this idea down, and conservative governor in Arizona, Jan Brewer, vetoed the idea because she said it would drive up the cost of borrowing to the state.
Is that a misreading of how this will handle it? I looked at the staff analysis. Deirdre McNabb is pointing out that in Colorado, for example, they had the tax provision back in the early 90s, and that had a lot to do with them controlling spending, but then, you know, a few years later, they actually rescinded it because they had a recession and they wanted to add some money to schools. So the question is, why do we have this? Why do we need this right now?
Well, I think it's common sense. What happens up in Tallahassee in any state capital, especially in Washington, D.C., when times are good, they overspend. What we want to say, when times are good, let's put a certain portion in the piggy bank. So when times go bad, we don't have to make those big cuts in schools and roads and health care. And the reason why this is so different than Colorado is that we learned from Colorado. First and foremost, I strongly believe in the idea of not overspending when times are good, so we can draw when times are bad. But let's add those three things. One is we have flexibility, unlike they had in Colorado. The state legislature, by a supermajority vote, can say we're going to break the cap this year because there are, let's just say, super needs. Second is the idea that we have the ability to put that money directly into the savings account. In Colorado, they had to refund it to taxpayers right away. And third and finally, in Colorado, it applied to the state and local governments. This is just for state government. And so when you see a policeman or fireman concerned about this, that doesn't directly affect police and fire. That's local government taxes. A lot of this comments are just kind of the usual hyperbole in political times.
Specifically, Deirdre, do you feel that social programs and education could take a beating if those dollars are not there in times of, let's say, another recession like we had in 08?
Well, let me say this. When Senator Haradopoulos talks about increased funding for education, which is just unbelievably part of the language, his nose has to be stretching all the way to Tallahassee, and I know he's standing in Winter Park right now. This is incredible. It has been a disaster in the state of Colorado. They've plummeted in funding for education from 35th to the bottom of the pack. Florida is already at the bottom of the pack in education funding. We can't afford a failed idea that has been tried in another state. People in Colorado are trying to get rid of it. And, you know, you can try to call this anything you want, and they've dressed it up as apple pie, but this is really apple pie and arsenic. This is a terrible idea. It's an idea that we can't afford in the state of Colorado. And frankly, Senator Haradopoulos, you're the only person in the state that I've heard speaking in favor of this amendment.
The only person?
Well, when I talk to people and I say, here's what we're going to do. When times are good, let's put money in the savings account. When times are bad, let's draw from that savings account. That's what every financial advisor tells us all to do, especially in these tough times. I think it's common sense. And people keep talking about Colorado. We're in Florida. We learn from the Colorado mistakes. And what we've done is we provided flexibility. That's what people want out of their government, reliable, not the up and down things.
Yeah.
And I'm an educator myself. The last thing I want to do is gut education. But in other states, that's exactly what they're doing because they spent too much when times were good.
All right. We're going to take a quick commercial break, and we're going to come back and continue our discussion on Amendment 3. You're watching Amendment 2012 Extra.